Hi everybody, Duke of the Bump here. Welcome to Let's Play Sonic Megamix. So yeah, who's excited for Sonic 4? I know I sure am. And in honor of this momentous occasion, I thought I would play one of the most beloved and respected ROM hacks of Sonic the Hedgehog out there. This is going to be a mostly blind LP. I basically just played through this level, the Sunny Shores Zone. Just to make sure that, you know, the ROM wasn't going to crap out on me halfway through or anything like that. Which, I mean, it still might. I recorded a test video of this, and, with some pretty disappointing results. Hopefully, this video will go a little better. If it doesn't, then you'll probably never even see it, so, you know, why worry about it? If this doesn't work out, I'll just play something else. Oh, goddammit. So yeah, I figure a lot of you have probably already played this game, but just in case, here's a quick rundown, damn it, of the mechanics. It's very similar to, you know, the Sonic we all know and love. You can jump, you can do a spin dash, and you can do the running spin dash from Sonic CD, which is kind of cool. But it also introduces some mechanics, or rather features some mechanics that were introduced in later Sonic games. For example, you have this janky ass homing attack thing, which, you know, works most of the time, but sometimes tends to home in on the wrong target. But it's kind of cool. It's a welcome addition to the game. I've heard a lot of people whining that Sonic 4 is going to have a homing attack, but you know, I think it's a pretty good addition. People are worried it's going to make the game too easy, which I think is kind of ridiculous, because if you're worried about that, you know, you don't have to use it. It's not a, you're not required to use the homing attack. I probably play through this entire game without using it once, but I use it because it's fun. But yeah, that's one of the new additions. And, as you can see, the level design, I mean, it's a remake of Sonic 1, so obviously it's going to crib a lot of elements from the original Sonic game, enemies and such, but it also takes a lot from the later Sonic games. For example, a lot of the music is lifted from later Sonic games. That was the ring dash, or the light dash, which was introduced in, I believe, the original Sonic Adventure, or possibly Sonic Adventure 2. Basically, there's an element from a later Sonic game, the lightning shield. Basically, if you're near a line of rings, you hit the A button and it'll dash along the line, which, you know, is not terribly useful, but I imagine there are sections designed where you're supposed to use that, like this, for example. And it's another cool... Damn it! It's another cool little feature. Yeah, I mean, even though I said I've played through this zone before, I really only played through it once and I wasn't really paying that much attention. So, yeah, I'm not going to be great at it. I considered just doing a straight run through of, you know, all of the, Sonic 3 music, I believe, of all of the original Sonic games. You know, by which I mean Sonic 1 through 3. Oh, I can't do the bubble shield bounce? That's kind of lame. Sonic 1 through 3 and Sonic & Knuckles. But, I just watched a stream where Ultra J-Man did pretty much the same thing. Although there was another guy in there who was doing Sonic ROM hacks in his stream. So, I realize I'm not being terribly original here. But, I mean, I don't know. Maybe doing a blind run will make it a little bit more entertaining. That was a Dr. Robotnik box, which was introduced in, was it Sonic CD, I think? Or maybe it was Sonic & Knuckles. But I was invincible, so it didn't matter. And that was a glitch. The invincibility music kind of went on a little longer than it should. Can't do the lightning shield jump either. That's disappointing. I was going to bounce my way up there. Oh well. The lightning shield, as you can see, attract rings to it, which negates your ability to use Al to use the ring dash, because the rings are like, you know, they're drawn to you before you can actually start moving along their path. So really, it's kind of a mixed blessing. I love the original Sonic games, though. I'm a big Sonic fan. And I really hope Sonic 4 is good. I mean, I'm gonna be pessimistic, just like probably everyone, but see, I don't know. I mean, pessimistically optimistic. Let's put it that way. I mean, I know it's probably not going to be good, but part of me can't help but hope that, you know, against all odds, they're going to make a good game. But I mean, it's not like Sonic hasn't made any good games since Sonic Adventure. The GBA games are pretty good. And the DS game, Sonic Rush. I never beat Sonic Rush or played the sequel, but I made it pretty far in the first one, and I enjoyed it. And I beat the first Sonic GBA game. But, you know, those are all made by Nymphs, I think they're called, not Sonic Team. So, I don't know. I'm not sure if this new game is going to be Nymphs or Sonic Team. It might be a collaboration between both. I think some recent Sonic games have used both of them. This is kind of a bad remix of the Green Hill Zone music. Oops. I don't know, it's just a little... aww. There's a little too much going on. It's a little too, a little too lively. Ugh! Oh, cool, a fire shield. Which probably doesn't do anything except protect me against fire. In Sonic 3 and Sonic & Knuckles, the fire shield gave you a little kind of fire boost thing. But that's sort of the same thing the homie attack does in this one. Damn it! If I can face the right way... look at that. Look. That is ridiculous. I'm facing towards the boss and it keeps making me... ugh. Keeps turning me around. How am I supposed to get that? I can't spin dash into it. If I jump, I'm going to jump above it. Maybe if I jump just a little bit and then do a homie attack. Alright, fuck it. Just a one-up. If this game's anything like the other Sonic games, I shouldn't have to worry about needing too many lives. And there's an instance when the ring dash just screws you. You use it and it hurls you into a Robotnik box. I know Sonic and Knuckles have Robotnik boxes, but they're like extremely rare. Like the only time I remember seeing them is in the Mystic Cave Zone. Maybe the bubble shield still helps you breathe underwater. That'd be cool. And that's really the best thing about the bubble shield. Of course, in Sonic and Knuckles, there are no water levels, so the bouncing is pretty much the only benefit you get from it. Which is why I'm disappointed. Oh, saw that coming. Damn, I have 11 rings. Whoa. Boss time. And it's just the same wrecking ball from Sonic 1. With a moving platform instead of two stationary platforms. Dang it. I'm not being very careful. See, my brain is telling me it's Sonic for the Genesis. You should be able to do this with half your brain tied behind your back. But like, my brain doesn't realize that, whoa. Oh yeah. There's like a little bit after the boss before you get to the animal containment unit. But yeah, my brain doesn't know that this is a completely new 16-bit Sonic game. For the Genesis, no less. Let's see if I can pull this off. It's gonna be pretty sweet. Damn it. Oh, oh well. Alright, this has been Let's Play Sonic Megamix. I'm Duke of the Bump. The rest of the videos, the rest of this game is going to be totally new to me. I stopped right after I beat the boss of this. So, yeah. Let's just take a sneak peek at what the next zone is going to be. Dark Fortress Zone. Interesting. Don't believe I've heard this music. The original music in this game isn't bad. I think this is original anyway. Oh well, I'm Duke of the Bump. Tune in next time for Dark Fortress Zone. Later.